So today we will be discussing ANOVAs, specifically the most simple form of ANOVA, a one-way between subjects ANOVA. A one-way ANOVA implies that there is only one independent variable, or a variable that we are manipulating, followed by one dependent variable. Furthermore, this independent variable has at least three levels. An ANOVA itself is an extension of a t-test, but is a special kind of t-test that is able to test multiple mean differences, which of course requires at least three means. If the independent variable only has two levels, it would just be a t-test. Furthermore, the independent variable must have levels, therefore it must be categorical or nominal, while the dependent variable needs to be on a continuous scale. Of course, we could potentially run a bunch of t-tests, but we don't. In essence, running a bunch of t-tests is cheating because it allows you to reject the null hypothesis more often than you should. So why is this one between subjects specifically? The independent variable allows each participant to be in exactly one level. If any participant is tested in multiple groups, then we would be running a repeated measures ANOVA. In the example today, participants will either get a placebo, or 1 milligram, or 2, or 3 milligrams, or 4, but no participant will receive 1 milligram and 4 milligrams and the placebo. It's one group or the other. So sticking with the ANOVA, we will begin by running the Omnibus ANOVA. An Omnibus test is one that tests for a significant difference in the experiment between at least two means, but it doesn't tell you between which two means it is. By running this first, we can assess if running other tests will even be worth our time. If the ANOVA turns out to be non-significant, then there is no significant difference between any of the means. So running other tests would also show that there is no difference. And that's just silly. So let's begin by looking at the data. You will see that the first column is a dosage of some made-up drug, doesn't matter which one. And this is the independent variable and will be between subjects because, again, no participant received multiple dosages of the drug. You either got 4 milligrams or 1 milligram, or you got a placebo. This variable is already coded so that 0 is the placebo, while 4 is 4 milligrams of the drug, and 1 is 1 milligrams of the drug, so on and so forth. It is important that the variable is set up in this manner, and this can be done by switching over to variable view. Be sure that the type of variable is set up as numeric. And feel free to add in your coding by clicking on the dot 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 over here in the values column. Here you can see I've coded 0 for placebo, 1 for 1 milligram, so on and so forth. Next, you will see that the second column, the average effect, is a dependent variable and is also numeric, but runs on a continuum. Again, it is important that the independent variable is categorical. You get 1 milligrams or 2, but you never get 1.5 milligrams. And that the dependent variable is continuous. The drug can have 50% effect, it can have 51% effect, it can have 51.462352% effect. Now for the Omnibus ANOVA. We'll go to Analyze, Compare Means, One-Way ANOVA. On the dependent list, we'll add the dependent variable. In this case, this was the effect of the drug. Click it over using the arrow. On the factor list, add the independent variable, which is the variable with the levels that we are manipulating. In this case, it will be the dosage of the drug. If you wish to just look at the ANOVA, you can go ahead and click OK. However, most of us will want to see not only the Omnibus test that informs us that, hey, listen, something here is significant. We also want to see what was significant. In order to do this, we'll need to run a post hoc test. That being the case, we will click on post hoc. You will see that there are a million options here, and there is no strict answer on which type of correction on a post hoc you should use. It's pretty much up to you. In this case, I'll go ahead and just use Bonferroni, but each correction has its pros and cons. The significance level is the p-value that you need to reject the null. The default is 0.05, but in some cases you may wish to change this to 0.01 or 0.10. All right, let's click continue, and then click OK now. And ta-da, there's your ANOVA, the end. Okay, but really, here's how to interpret this mess of numbers. The ANOVA will give us an array of information, including the F value. The F value is a ratio of good variance to bad variance. Good variance is a variation of scores that is due to our experiment, or the variance between the means. Bad variance is the variation of scores that is due to the peopleness of people, or the variation of scores within each group, or what we usually just call individual differences. When the F value is high, we have a lot of good variance compared to bad variance, and chances are that our independent variable manipulation influenced scores based on our dependent variable changes. The ANOVA will also give the p-value, which of course indicates that the null hypothesis should be rejected or not. Since I determined that my p-value needs to be less than 0.05, and in this case it was less than 0.001, some mean somewhere is significantly different from some other mean somewhere. As of right now, I have no idea where, but it's in there, and it's worth looking at those post-hoc tests later. The degrees of freedom between groups will be k minus 1, where k is the number of levels in our independent variable. In this case, we had 5 levels, the placebo, and 1 milligram, 2 milligrams, 3 milligrams, and 4 milligrams of the drug. So that's 5 levels, minus 1 is 4. So there's the degrees of freedom for between groups. The degrees of freedom within groups is slightly more complicated, and is n minus 1 but for each level, where n is the number of participants in that specific level. For the placebo group, there were 20 people. So 20 minus 1 is 19, plus for the 1 milligram group, there were also 20 people, so 20 minus 1, which is 19, plus 20 people in the 2 milligram group, so on and so forth. When you add all this together, it's 95. The sum of squares and the mean square value are necessary for calculating the F ratio, but for the sake of simplicity and the fact that these values are not usually reported, I won't go ahead and discuss those in very much detail. Again, you can find these values on the ANOVA table provided. So here we have the between groups degrees of freedom, the within groups degrees of freedom, the total degrees of freedom, our F value, and our P value. We will report the Omnibus ANOVA in this manner. F parentheses degrees of freedom, comma degrees of freedom, parentheses equals F value, comma P value. So in this case, F parentheses 4, the degrees of freedom between groups, comma 95, the degrees of freedom within groups, parentheses equals 168, which is the F value, and our P is less than 0.001. Remember, when reporting a p-value, write the exact value of p unless it is less than 0.001. If this is the case, just report it as p less than 0.001. So since this was significant, let's take a look at the post hoc test to determine where the significance is coming from. It could be that there's a significant difference between all levels of the drug, or it could be that there's only a significant difference between the placebo and 4 milligrams, or only between 2 and 3 milligrams. The post hoc test will show a comparison between each and every level. Here we see the placebo being compared to 1 milligram, the placebo to 2, placebo to 3, placebo to 4, 1 milligram to placebo, 1 milligram to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4, and so on. The sig column will provide the p-value for each comparison. In this case, most levels are significantly different from every other level, except for the difference between 2 milligrams and 3 milligrams, which you can see right here and here. Between these two dosages, the average effect score was virtually the same, or at least it wasn't significantly different. The mean difference will indicate the difference between the average score for each of the levels, and the 95% confidence interval is for the mean difference. For instance, the mean difference between the placebo and 1 mg is -20.44, and the 95% confidence interval would be reported as -26 and -15. In most cases, this would simply be written up as there was a significant difference between the average effect of the placebo and 1 mg, p less than 0.001. So this ANOVA has proven that overall, somewhere, some of the averages between the levels were significantly different, and our post hoc tests indicated exactly which averages were significantly different and which ones were not. And that's how to run a one-way between subjects ANOVA.